ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। वेलकम टू लक्ष्य अकेडमी यूट्यूब चैनल। ओके, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज रेगुलेशन ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी मूवमेंट्स। दिस इज द पार्ट 13 ऑफ ब्रीथिंग एंड एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैस। ओके, इन द प्रीवियस पार्ट पार्ट 12 वी लर्न ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड। ओके, इन दिस पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न रेगुलेशन ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी मूवमेंट्स। वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक। स्टूडेंट्स फील अ लिटिल बिट डिफिकल्ट इन दिस एरिया। ओके, ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड रेगुलेशन ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी लिटिल बिट डिफिकल्ट कंपेयर टू रिमेनिंग टॉपिक्स। ओके, जनरली मोस्ट ऑफ द बिट्स आर गिवेन फ्रॉम respiratory volumes and capacities and from transport of oxygen, carbon dioxide and regulation of respiratory movements. Mainly three topics are very important for NEET, especially disorders of respiratory system, respiratory volumes and capacities, transport of oxygen, carbon dioxide, okay, oxyhemoglobin dissociation curve. In the transport of oxygen, you come across that one. These four are very very important. Okay, then okay, regulation of respiratory movements. Okay, respiratory rhythmic center. Okay, the human beings have the significant ability to maintain and moderate the respiratory rhythm to suit the demands of the body. Okay, our body demands of our body for oxygen changes. Okay, our body sometimes requires more oxygen, our body tissues sometimes require more oxygen, sometimes our body tissues require less oxygen. When you do more exercise, the demand for oxygen increases from the tissues. That means our body needs are not same all the time. For example, when you are running, your body requirements of oxygen changes. You need more oxygen. When you are climbing, ascending the steps of a building, you require more oxygen. Human beings have the significant ability to maintain and moderate the respiratory rhythm to suit the demands of the body. Okay, your heart rhythm also changes. For example, sometimes your heart beats more fast. That means lubbed up sounds move. They are produced quicker. When your results, exam results are just going to out, at that time you are very anxious, your heart beat increases, lubbed up sounds, rhythm increases. Like that we have respiratory rhythm, inspiration, expiration. When you are doing exercise, when you are running, at that time your inspiration and expiration rhythm changes. This is a respiratory rhythm. The respiratory rhythm changes according to the demands of our body tissue. This how is this respiratory rhythm can be changed according to the needs of the body tissues. Okay, there is a system which is regulating this one, that is called neural system or nervous system is there behind this one. A specialized center is present in the medulla region, very important, medulla region of the brain. That means medulla oblongata region of the brain, that is called respiratory rhythm center. Okay, I will show you that respiratory rhythm center. This is the respiratory rhythm center. Respiratory rhythm center, RRC, respiratory rhythm center, which is this part of the brain is called, this is the medulla oblongata. Okay, in the medulla oblongata, what is this respiratory rhythm center? In the respiratory rhythm center, there is a dorsal respiratory group and ventral respiratory group is there. Here I am giving a flow chart. It is very important. Note down this one. It is not given in our textbook also. Okay, these points, some of the points are additional points are there to understand this concept in a better, okay, to give better understanding of this topic. Okay, I have given this one. Okay, note down this chart. Neural regulation. Respiratory rhythmic center is present in the medulla oblongata of the brain. In this respiratory rhythmic center, RRC, there are two groups are there. You can observe one group here, one MPC group, IPC group, like that. Here there are two groups are there. One is dorsal DRG, another one VRG. DRG, VRG. Dorsal respiratory group and ventral respiratory group. Okay, dorsal respiratory group consists of one center called inspiratory center, and this consists of a center called expiratory center here. Okay, inspiratory center, expiratory center. Inspiratory area, expiratory area. Okay, now let us talk about the first, this one, okay, dorsal respiratory group. Okay, this one sending signals, it is sending signals to whom? It is sending signal, it is sending signals to, through these nerves, it is sending signals to two part. One is that, okay, in external intercostal muscles, external intercostal muscles, you learn these muscles in the mechanism of respiration, and also diaphragm muscles called phrenic muscles. Signals are sent to these muscles, diaphragm muscles and external intercostal muscles. Who is sending signal? Dorsal respiratory group, which consists of neuron, they are sending signals to, okay, these two parts. What happens then? When signals have reached this part, these muscles, what happen? Contraction takes place in those muscles. When the contraction of diaphragm muscles and external intercostal muscles takes place, what happens? Thoracic cavity volume, this pulmonary cavity volume increase. When thoracic cavity volume increase, pulmonary cavity volume also increases. When the volume increases, you know, as boils, pressure decrease. When the pressure decreases in our lungs compared to atmospheric air, air enters into our lungs. That is called inspiration. Okay, in this way, inspiration right now in your body, inspiration and expiration taking place because of this, all this is, this mechanism is going in our body. Okay, you don't know about that. Okay, specialized center present in the medulla oblongata region of the brain called respiratory rhythm center in the primary, which is primarily responsible for this regulation. Okay, next one. Now you are also inspiring, you are also expiring. How respiration occurs? Dorsal respiratory group, which consists of inspiratory center, it is sending signals for relaxation of muscles. Relaxation of which muscles? Same muscles now relax. Okay, therefore, the quite opposite thing here. Thoracic cavity volume and pulmonary cavity volume decrease, here increase. Okay, when the thoracic cavity volume decreases, pulmonary cavity volume decreases, pressure increases according to Boyle's law. Okay, therefore, this pressure in the lungs is higher than the compared to atmospheric pressure. Therefore, air goes outside. That is called expiration. Okay, in this way, inspiration and expiration take place regulated by, okay, this dorsal respiratory group. Next center is the pneumotoxic center. Where is this center? Another center. That means already we discussed one center, RRC, respiratory rhythmic center. Okay, now we are going to discuss another center. What is this center? This is the pneumotoxic center. Okay, another center present in the pons region of the brain. Where is this one? This is present in the pons veroli. This is called pons veroli of the brain, hind brain. Pons veroli. This pons veroli of the brain consists of a center called pneumotaxic center. What is this center? Pneumotaxic center, and which can moderate the functions of respiratory rhythmic center. Now it is sending signals to the respiratory rhythmic center. That means it is controls the functions of this one. Okay, neural signal. Now you can observe here, it is sending a signal, neural signal, to what? To respiratory rhythmic center. A neural signal from this center can reduce the duration of inspiration and thereby alter the risk. What is the respiratory rate? Amount, number of times you breathe per minute is the respiratory. What is the normal respiration rate? Earlier you learnt in the pulmonary volumes and capacity, 12 to 16 times is the normal respiratory rate. For example, okay, normal respiratory rate is, for example, 15 times per minute. Imagine when you are doing normal breathing. Okay, during quiet breathing, normal breathing, when you start doing exercise, okay, when you are doing vigorous exercise, okay, during that time, okay, your respiration rate increases to 20 times, assume so. Okay, your normal breathing, normal respiratory rate 15 times per minute. When you do vigorous exercise, that 15 times has become 20 times. Okay, that means you are breathing more. 15 times you are breathing for 1 minute. 1 minute means 60 seconds. By 15 breathing, 15, 60 by 15, that means 15 once 4. That means for each breathing, it is taking 4 seconds. When I do exercise, what is happening? When I do exercise, Now I am breathing for 60 seconds. I am breathing 20 times. Okay, 21, 23. That means my breathing duration for each breathing reduced to 3 seconds, especially inspiration. Okay, why it has reduced to 3? Because from 4 to 3, because this center is going to play an important role here. Neural signal from this center can reduce the duration. Now the duration has reduced from 4 to 3. Can reduce the duration of the inspiration. Therefore, alter, change your respiratory rate. Earlier 15, now it has changed to 20 times. Okay, Pons Veroli consists of pneumothoraxic center. Okay, pneumothoraxic, one more important point related to this one. When a faster rate of breathing is needed, for example, when you are doing exercise, at the time you need a faster rate of breathing, that means more than normal. Okay, pneumothoraxic center then sends signals to dorsal respiratory groups to speed up your breathing. Now come to the chemosensitive area. Okay, chemosensitive area is situated adjacent to the RRC, respiratory rhythmic center. Okay, this is the respiratory rhythmic center. Okay, in this respiratory rhythmic center, again there I told you in the previous slides, there is a DRG, dorsal respiratory group of group, and ventral respiratory group of neurons. Okay, now I am taking these two as one thing here, that is respiratory rhythmic center. This is respiratory rhythmic center, and here there is another area adjacent to this one. దీని పక్కనే ఉంది, అడ్జసెంట్ టు దిస్ వన్, రెస్పిరేటరీ రిథమిక్ సెంటర్ కి పక్కనే. వాట్ ఈస్ ద కీమోసెన్సిటివ్ ఏరియా? ఇదంతా ఎక్కడ ఉన్నాయంటే మెడుల్లా అబ్లాంగేటర్, దట్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ మెడుల్లా అబ్లాంగేటర్ నౌ దేర్ ఆర్ టూ ఏరియాస్ ఆర్ దేర్. వన్ ఈజ్ వన్ ఈస్ ద రెస్పిరేటరీ రిథమిక్ సెంటర్, ద అదర్ వన్ ఇస్ ద కీమోసెన్సిటివ్ ఏరియా. వాట్ ఈస్ ద సిగ్నిఫికెన్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ కీమోసెన్సిటివ్ ఏరియా విచ్ ఇస్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ ద మెడుల్లా అబ్లాంగేటర్? A chemosensitive area is situated next to, adjacent to the respiratory rhythmic center. It is chemosensitive area is highly sensitive to CO2 and hydrogen ion. For example, whenever there is a high PCO2 in our blood, there is high H plus ion in our blood, it can be detected by this chemo, means chemicals. Okay, when these chemicals increase in our blood, they can be detected by chemosensitive area. Increase in these substances, when these two increase in our body, can activate this center. This center is activated, and which in turn can signal the respiratory rhythmic center. Observe here. Now it is sending signals. It is sending signals to what? It is sending signals to respiratory rhythmic center to make necessary adjustment, because if it is very harmful. Presence of high carbon dioxide, it is very harmful to our body, it has to be eliminated from our body. Now it is sending signals to the respiratory rhythm center to make necessary adjustments to send that carbon dioxide, expel carbon dioxide from our body. Increase in these substances can activate this center, which in turn can signal the respiratory center, respiratory rhythmic center, to make necessary adjustments in the respiratory process, and by which carbon dioxide and H plus ions are eliminated from the body. Chemosensitive area of brainstem. What is brainstem? Brainstem is equal three parts. I am showing you. This is the midbrain, and this is the pons veroli, this is the medulla oblongata, and this is the spinal cord. What is this one? This is the midbrain, and this is the pons veroli, and this is the medulla oblongata, and these three parts together we call brain stem. Very important. Brain stem is called, a tree has a stem, like our brain also has a stem. Brain stem has midbrain, medulla pons veroli, and medulla oblongata from up top to bottom. Okay, chemosensitive area is present in this part. In the medulla oblongata, there is respiratory rhythmic center, and also chemosensitive area. In this pons veroli, we have pneumothoraxic center is present here. Pneumothoraxic center, chemosensitive area of the brainstem, and brainstem and total brainstem, look at the medulla oblongata alone. Highly sensitive area of the ventral medulla surface, responsive to the changes to blood PCO2 and H plus ion concentration and stimulates the other of the respiratory center to make necessary adjustments. And receptors associated with the aortic and carotid artery also can recognize changes in CO2 and H plus concentration. Okay, as I told you, chemosensitive area can recognize the changes in H plus and CO2 concentration. And in addition to that, there are receptors. Okay, where are they? I will show you here. There are receptors in the, this is called aortic arch. In the aortic arch here, there are receptors called chemoreceptor, and this is called carotid artery. Carotid artery also carotid body. In the carotid body, there are chemoreceptor. Okay, these chemoreceptors also, they can detect high CO2 and high H plus in our blood. Receptors associated with present in aortic arch, and this one aortic arch and carotid artery. This is the carotid artery and the carotid, there is a carotid body in the carotid body and aortic body, and which consists of chemoreceptor. Okay, they recognize the changes in CO2. Whenever there is a high CO2 and H plus concentration, they can recognize and send necessary signals to the respiratory rhythmic center for remedial actions. Okay, they should not be in excess in our body. They have to be sent out. Okay, now the receptor sending information. They are sending information. Okay, from these receptor, the information is going to your brain. Okay, medulla oblongata. It makes necessary adjustment to send that carbon dioxide, excess carbon dioxide from the body. The role of oxygen in this regulation of respiratory rhythm is quite insignificant. The role of oxygen in the regulation of respiratory rhythm is quite insignificant. Okay, that's the end of this regulation of respiratory movements. Chemoreceptor, aortic body sends feedback to medulla. Okay, along vagus nerve and carotid body. It is not part of your syllabus. And carotid body sends feedback to medulla along the glossopharyngeal nerve. These nerves carrying information to the brain regarding high PCO2 and H plus ion concentration. Okay, that's the end of this topic. We have one more topic in this lesson. Okay, occupational respiratory disorders. With that, this chapter will be completed.